Okay, so this one, 1093, we just went in for a three contract position here. We are flat on Google. Let's just watch the market watch. On Google, the trade price was $5. And so we have three contracts. And so that would be a, what is it, a $1,500 trade? Is that what it is? And so we are down, yeah, close to about 20%, just a little over 20%. So it may be worthwhile to sort of double down here. So I'm not going to double down. I'm just going to add two because, all right, so I'm just going to add two at 390, and that will make it a five contract position. And so this would be a five contract at 4.5 average price. So that's about a $2,200 trade at this point. But you cannot double down indefinitely because, I mean, that's not a winning strategy at all. The next step would be a debit spread. I want to see, I want to give it another chance for Google to try to make, you know, find its way out of the hole that we are in. But if not, I'll take it into tomorrow and just make it a spread again. It's down now $800. So we need to do something about this and just keep it like that for the day. So this is what I'm suggesting. So this is a slightly more advanced technique. So let's look at that. So we have five contracts on the long side. So now if you wanted to make it a credit spread, you would sell the 1097.5. We're getting about 2.85 or perhaps more. We'll get about $3 and something because the bid ask is quite wide. I'll sell just, you know, either four or three. So that way we don't have an, a sort of a risk reward that is too crazy. So here we go. So if you look at this, sell minus four, and let's go to our risk profile here. Okay, so this is the risk profile. So here we are. If I do that, I cannot go down any further because, you know, this is where it is right now. I cannot go down any further than that. Okay, now if I sell five, then it becomes a credit spread. So, you know, we are down maybe what, right now we're down 967. And if you look at this, you know, we can go down 2000. So, you know, I don't want to do that. So I'm just going to sell four and I'll leave it like this because this gives me time decay. Here, I'll sell four and at least hedge the position for today. All right, got filled. Okay. Okay. So this is our position right now. So any movement up will improve our situation. Any movement down will have no effect. Okay. So that's where I want to leave it for today. I'll speak to you guys tomorrow. This is a trade in trouble. It had to come at some point, and so we're going to deal with that. We'll take it into tomorrow. I'll speak to you guys tomorrow. Thank you. I'm going to just look at the market watch here, and here I know there are other stocks also that we can look at, but as of now, that's not my focus. I'm focusing on Google because we want to make sure that we can, you know, salvage this trade. So here we are. We have a positive delta here, 58 positive deltas. Let's see, 570. And this is 1107.5. Okay, all right. So we got it at 590. We are still down about 550 on this trade, okay? We are still down about 550 on this trade. I think we got the debit spread in at the right time because we got 5.9. You know, it was going for like 7.5 and 8. So as Google went down, we got into the debit spread, which is good. That bar was good on Google, not so good on the S&P. That was a decent bar on Google as well as the S&P, but there was some selling coming in at the end over there on the S&P. So this bar is going to end. It's looking promising on the S&P. Now, granted, there's going to be a battle over there. And so, you know, there's a battle between the bulls and the bears going on. Both Google and Boeing are pretty well correlated right now. So it looks like some selling on this bar, definitely, because higher volume and it got pushed down to close to the bottom. So definitely some selling there. Boeing is still looking strong. Okay, Boeing is still looking strong. Yes, definitely ES turning around over the last, if you look at the last three or four bars, definitely turning around. This was the only weak bar. I think there was definitely some selling there, but it's looking better. It's looking better and better. But the goal is to have the P&L for the day come to 750. If the P&L for the day comes to 750, then we've broken even on the trade. Now, it doesn't mean that I'm going to wait till it gets to 750. If it gets to 400 or 500, you know, I have no problem taking a losing trade because that's what the game is. You know, we've had 10 winners in a row. And so it's you know, a losing trade is bound to come our way. And the key is you just don't lose too much on the losing trade. That's all. If anybody was in the Boeing trade, that would have been a good exit. It did do a high over there. Okay, 21%. All right, Juan. Awesome. Okay, closed out. Yeah, okay. All right. Excellent. Yeah, I was just going to say, because Boeing made a nice move there. Okay, so this one is up 688. Okay, this one is up 688. I'll tell you what, I'll take a profit on half of it. So I'm going to buy back two of those and book about $300 profit. Okay, the calculations we can do, you know, even later, because we can run a report on that. So I'm not particularly concerned about that. But I think we booked perhaps 623, 313, exactly half of this. Yeah, so $300 we booked a profit on that. And because the markets look like they want to move up, so let's try to make the best out of it. So we have plus five, minus two. Okay, nice move up there. Let's see where we are. All right, we are up 266 for the day. That was a good move on all the stocks as well as the S&P. Google's moved into very bullish. Of course, right now it's in a transition state. So it can move from very bullish back to neutral or something like that, because it just moved into very bullish. So we have to see, it might go back into neutral. But regardless, at least some of the internals are telling us that, okay, things are looking okay for Google. Alphabet is now 1107. Sorry, I did that thing again. Let's go back to monitor. We are up 432 for the day. Now we are 470, 450. So I would say totally about 700. We are required 570 plus 200, 770. Okay, guys, this is good. All right, so I'm going to first close this short off. We got a profit there still. So I'm going to buy it, buy two at four. Let's do it. All right. Yeah, should get a better price, 370. Now it's gone up to 1108. So where do we stand? 797. So this brings us to break even on the trade for 829. We are actually up a little bit. So sell 5, 930, 960. 960. Google's moving up nicely. Let's see the monitor again. 1058. Now we are clearly in the profit here. Clearly in the profit. Okay. I'm going to close it because we've been fighting with this trade from yesterday, and I want to get 950, in which case it'll be about a 900 plus 200, 1100. Ultimately, we will be plus on this trade if we can get this order filled here at 950. So turning, okay, 950, exactly. So we made 900 today, and yesterday we made 200. So that's 1150. And you know, we were down 950 at the end. So the way to look at it is yesterday's video. If you catch the end of that video, when we converted this into a minus four and plus five, you know, the loss at that point was about 950 or 960 or something like that. So and then it ended, or rather this morning, it started out where, you know, we had already recovered 200 from yesterday's action, and today we did 990. So we can do the reports later, but basically, I think we are slightly up. Of course, granted, there'll be some pretty decent commission costs on this trade because we did go in and out quite a bit. So this is good, guys. This is the way you want to recover a losing trade, because if you fight for your losers, the winners will come. The winners will come. You have to fight for your losers. And that's exactly what we did today. And that's what I wanted to sort of convey in this session today. So if you want a free trial of this day trading signal service, you can go to this bit.ly link. It's bit.ly slash day hyphen signals. Now the day and the D and the S has to be capitals. And once you go there, you can get a free trial. You'll need to sign up there and you'll get a free trial. And at the end of 1 week, if you don't want to continue, you can just send us an email at info@optiontiger.com and we'll give you a full refund. So once again, the bit.ly link is bit.ly slash day hyphen signals with the DNS in caps. Thank you.